What's up, game devs? As you requested, today you can find the second part of the drag and drop tutorial. We're going to see how to handle a drop, in particular how to snap the item inside another one, like an inventory slot, avoid overlapping items with a quick reposition, and make an item go back to its previous position if the drop should fail. If you already have a solid drag and drop implementation, you can find in this video some additional features you could use. Otherwise, feel free to watch the first video to have the basic implementation up and running, then come back here to make it even better. Enough talking for now, let's begin! First of all, we need to create an additional layer we're gonna use for items being moved. As usual, to avoid mistakes, let's also create a script to hold the layer IDs instead of using plain strings every time in the code. It's now time to add some code to our draggable script. We'll also need a public reference to our last drag item from the drag controller. We should now create an update drag status method that sets our drag controller flag, as we already do in the init drag and drop, but also take care of the correct layer. As usual, you can write a longer if statement if you want, but I like to keep the code short when possible. Now let's call this method in our init drag and drop. In order to avoid collisions while the item is being dragged, we need to set up on project settings physics2d the interaction between layers and disable it from to our dragging layer. Let's add some references on our draggable class to its collider and then to the drag controller instance. Collider can be found with getComponent, while DragController will be the only active instance in the scene, so we can find it via findObjectOfType. On our triggerEnterToD method, we check if the other item is a draggable. This will be required to avoid overlapping items. In this case, we want to reposition the item that is being dragged. We can use distance between the two colliders to get a vector tree pointing to the minimum distance to avoid overlapping. With that vector tree, we can move our item. Now, let's see if it works. And it does not. That's because at this point we need to add the rigidbody 2D to our items and also set the isTrigger flag to true on the colliders. Oh, right. We also forgot that we need to change the layer of the draggable item and not the drag controller. Cool, now everything should work, and as you can see, while dragging nothing happens because the item is on a different layer. And then, when I finally release the mouse, the collider is triggered and the item repositioned at the closest valid position. It's now time to add a couple slots so we can test our two other features. We can use tags to recognize if the drop will be valid or not, and give them an intuitive color. Oh, and don't forget the collider. On our draggable item now, we need to set up the structure to make the item move smoothly rather than instantly. We can expand the trigger method and see if we collided with an item of one of the two tags we just created. If we drop on the valid target, set our destination to its center. Otherwise, we're on an invalid target, we move back to our previous position. To make it move, we can use fixed update. We check if there's a destination set, and we can do that because it's a nullable item. If we drag the item again while it's repositioning, we just remove the destination. If our current position equals the destination, we set the layer to default to re-enable collisions. Otherwise, we smoothly move with vector3.lerp. The last position is set from the drag controller when we begin our drag. With that done, we can finally see the result. Oh, cool! And, looks like I put the wrong names somewhere. Yeah, that's why using constants is usually a solid idea. Great! We can now snap our diamond inside the green slot and prevent any drop on the red slot instead, while overlapping is still handled properly. And that was it for this second and final part of the drag and drop tutorial. Let me know in the comments if you're going to use it for your game, and feel free to ask any question, I try to answer to everyone. If you like this video, don't forget to also subscribe to the channel to get notified when new game dev content will be out. Until then, have a great day!